知几时开始，我好耐冇瞓过觉啦，所以我就喺呢个城市周围行下，打发下时间啦。呢度好多地方都买得到咖啡，唔错噶。
Come on, I have to have some coffee。
我边行边睇，望住呢个城市边缘过后嘅大海。唔知道大海过后又会有啲乜嘢呢？我唔敢过去，我始终净系一个姑娘仔。你好，我叫于美。这个城市有点怪怪地，好像所有的东西都只是一个假象来的。啲大厦、树、车、烟，全部都是幻象来的。但没可能啊，我摸得到他们，闻得到他们，没可能是假的。难道我被人骗？
A straight wave runs into a straight barrier and reflects.
Down to 晚上仲惨。有好多我打唔开嘅门，啲门后面又有乜嘢呢？我过唔到去，又点会知啊？仲有个月亮，冇人睇住嘅时候，仲会唔会喺度啊？唔知啊，咁耐冇瞓，好难专心谂嘢嘅。
Would you like to see the eighth wonder of the world?
What are you selling, Mr.
Books? Go to books.
I like it. Sexy.
Sexy? Well, what I'm about to show you is even sexy.
Show me.
I introduced you.Speckers, Timber Rick.
The cup game. That's it. You're wasting my time, Mr. Burns.
Now, why would I be wasting my time on a girl like you?What do you say? Would you like to play?
What if I lose?
What if you lose? Of course you will.
Let's play.
One, two, three. Three, two, one. Now keep your eyes on the cup, keep your eyes on the cups. At most, there can be one coin beneath each one of these cups.So what you have to do is pick any two cups. But you think are both full or both empty. Oh, come on now, don't be shy, give it a try.
Two and three. Empty.
Fool.
Sorry.
One and two. Empty.
Wrong again.
For the game. It's a good one.
How much do I loathe that con man? Well, okay. I bought it from the world's greatest magician, John Bell.
John Bell?
John Bell. He gave me this picture. I see some symbols on the board. Do you think maybe the answers to solving this predicament is written on the board? Maybe you will know. The ring is his too.
I much prefer this.
I get to keep the ring. You can try looking. Just like you, many times I have failed. And I've not slept a wink ever since I got this temple.
Feeling mighty lonesome, haven't slept a wink. I walk the floor and watch the door, and in between I drink black coffee.
But will this cup of coffee taste as good as it smells?
I'll never know a Sunday in this weekday room. I'm talking to the shadows from 1 o'clock to 4, and Lord, how slow the moments go when all I do is pour black coffee.
就系呢个啦，证据啊！呢个游戏照理讲应该唔会一味输噶，但系我就一次都冇赢过，所以我眼前嘅有可能全部都系假嘅，就好似电影嘅布景咁，假象嚟嘅啫。但系呢个俾我游戏嘅 Kuta Books 又好似有啲信唔过喎、啊， 佢话呢个游戏系一个叫做 Bell John Bell 嘅人俾佢嘅。如果佢讲嘅系真嘅，咁呢个唔合理嘅游戏就真系存在，呢个世界就真系假嘅。喺啲古惑仔电影入边，如果有假嘅嘢，佢哋就会讲 Fugazi。Fugazi。
Hi.
Hi.
You are?
My name is Eckert, Arthur Eckert. And you?
My name's Yume.
You play games, Yume. What kind of game is this?
There are three cups, and each time I open two cups. And the strange thing is, if I play this long enough, there should be some cases where I get too empty or too full. But every time that I play it, it's always one empty and one full.But that's impossible, right?
Well, it seems so. But there are many strange things. This one is interesting. It is interesting because there are many games of that kind that quantum physicists can explain. Things are somewhat different in the quantum world. But this one is difficult.I know many similar games, and even those games are difficult to explain because everyone seems to have different explanation. You talk to mathematicians, they will tell you about some problems with logic or some frustrated graphs. You talk to philosophers, they will talk about contextuality. And you talk to physicists, and then you'll get all kind of different answers, really. Some will tell you thatthings do not exist until you look at them. Somehow they pop up into existence the moment you look at them. And there's even more bizarre interpretation of what's going on. And that is that objects do not exist exactly as we see them, that they exist in many copies of themselves. It's called the many-world or the Everett interpretation. And to be honest, I like this one.
No! It's terrific!
It is something that tells that the things are real, that there is a real existence up there. But you know, this one cannot be explained even with that interpretation. It really means that either you are cheated here or that you are dreaming.
But what about this man? His name is John Bell. Do you know anything about him?
John Bell? Yeah, never met him. Yume, about this game, how about if I buy it from you?
I think I'll keep it.
Arthur 真是一个古怪的男人，他的样子好像 Ben Kingsley， 又或者是以前的科幻片里面的男主角。他说连世界这样东西都可以有好多可能性，咁系乜意思呢？佢又话呢个游戏系唔存在嘅，只有两个方法可以解释。第一就系有人呃我，第二我喺度发梦，我瞓唔着啊！呢个游戏系唔系有人喺度操纵呢？但是 我又唔见有机关喎。
What's up?
Atta sent me.
Uh-huh.
He said you can explain this to me. I have this game, and when I raise two cups, it's always one full and one empty. But in some cases, I should get two full or two empty, right?
It depends on the game. Can you play it once? Oh, you have one of those weird coins. Okay, I see. I also have one. And with two of them, we can play a much more interesting game. Yeah, so let's play once or twice this game, just to see for you how it goes. Okay, toss the coin. Take your coin and toss it. What did you see?
Heads.
I also get heads. Try it again. Now, what is it now?
Heads.
Heads again. Solve with me. And if we continue many times, it will always happen that you and I will see the same outcome.
How can you tell just two throws?
Because I've done it many times myself. If I want, I can give you this coin and then you do practice at home. You want it? No. Okay. Okay, so you see these coins are correlated. We are playing a game with two people now. The game you are playing before, you can play yourself. But it's really important. What is really fascinating is when you start playing at a distance. You see, these two coins behave as if they are receiving the same instruction. It's easy to think that my coin has an instruction. It feels the motion of my finger. But how comes that both coins receive the same instruction? It seems that there is something like a mysterious connection, or maybe they don't receive any instruction. Okay, now with coins, you know, it works only in dreams, but in reality, it does work. You need quantum physics. You need two quantum objects. Do you know what is a quantum object?
No.
Something like an atom or a photon, something very small. Maybe something bigger also. Also bigger things obey quantum mechanics. But let's think of two atoms or two photons. Okay? Now you take these two quantum objects and you prepare them in what is called an entangled state. Now, what is an entangled state? Well, that's very hard to explain. But I can tell you how it's related with our game with coins. And this is what I'm going to do now, what I'm going to write down now is very similar to what John Bell proved. Do you know John Bell?
Yes. The guy who gave me this got it from John Bell.
Oh, okay. Okay. So you see, we go back to him now. Now, what we found before, what we were looking for, is the probability that your coin, let me call it A, gives the same result as my coin, let's call it B. This fits Alice and Bob. We call them normally Alice and Bob, the two players. Okay, now I have to do a little bit more of tricks here. You see, I have to put some numbers. A sum here. And then this simple mathematical object, without entanglement, without these weird correlations, it will be smaller or equal than 2. Now, this is called a Bell inequality. Inequality because, as you see here, there is a sign smaller or equal than 2. And what you can do with quantum mechanics, with entanglement, is that you can violate this inequality. You can get a value for this number that is higher than 2. In fact, you can go up to square root of 2 plus 1, which is approximately 2.4. And now, when you violate this inequality, you can certify that there is real randomness in nature. And this is fantastic because we are no longer slaves of determinism in physics.
Don't ever want to say. 又话呢个游戏唔系真嘅，又俾我睇第二个，佢话系真嘅铜板游戏。我好想瞓觉啊！佢仲喺个板度写啲数学文字，话证明呢个世界系可以发生啲奇奇怪怪嘅事，一个我可能推测嘅世界。咁系乜意思呢？
Ayumi, I hear that you have a problem with the game.
And you're here to help me?
Maybe I can. But how?
I have a game. Every time I open two cups, it's always one full, one empty.
But it's not possible to always have one full and one empty without ever getting two full or two empty. It's just not possible.
But Valerio, he said in quantum physics there are some things that defy common sense.
There are things in quantum physics that defy common sense as we know it from our everyday experience. But even the laws of quantum physics do not allow the situation of the game that you just described. So even in quantum physics, this is impossible.
Then what's real? What's unreal? What is reality?
Well, reality is what you perceive. So, you are real, I am real, the chairs we are sitting in are real.
I researched about John Bell, and he suggested an experiment to prove that reality doesn't exist.People conducted the experiment and the findings supported his expectations.
Indeed, there was such a suggestion by Bell and there were such experiments. And the findings of these experiments perfectly agree with the predictions of quantum mechanics, which are also Bell's predictions for the outcome, and thereby they contradict his notion of reality. They do notinvalidate reality as such, because these experiments of course are real, the outcomes of these experiments are real. So the contradiction is in an imagined reality that Bell would like to have, but it turns out that the world is not the way Bell wants it to be. It has its own properties.
But I know that Bell had his misgivings about quantum physics.
Yes, indeed. Bell was unhappy about some ways quantum physics is practiced, but this unhappiness had no real foundation. You see, when we apply the laws of quantum physics to describe any physical phenomena, we single out a few features that really require a quantum description, and everything else is described in the language of classical physics. So here is a small piece of the experiment is really relevant in its quantum aspects, and the rest of it, it doesn't need a detailed quantum description. Now, where to draw this line depends on the application, depends on the precision that you need in the description of the experiment. So there simply cannot be a general rule of how to do it. It's a practitioner's choice in every single case. In the end, it means that we have a division into a world of quantum phenomena embedded in a world of classical physics. So imagine that you are sitting on the beach. In front of you is the water, where you have the ships swimming and the fish inside the water, so that's the ocean. Behind you, you have houses, bicycle riders, maybe people sitting on a bench. That's the land. So there's the ocean in front of you, the land behind you. There is no line on the beach that distinguishes the ocean from the land, in the sense that on one side of the line there's the ocean, on the other side of the line there is the beach. You can draw lines that do approximately describe where the ocean ends and the land begins, but there is no unique choice for that line on the beach. So, the concepts of ocean and land have their meaning even without having such a clear division between the two. It is quite like that when it comes to the quantum world and the classical world. We know they exist, we know how to study the phenomena in the quantum realm, we know how to study the phenomena of classical physics, but we do not have a sharp division that tells us on this side there is only classical physics and on that side there is only quantum physics. This is the major misgiving that Bell had about
quantum theory. There is a smart person who said this game is definitely false, and Valerio's twin-game is true. And then he said John Bell is wrong, and the sea, which I never thought of in my life. 真实和虚幻的边界是一个不能定位的界线，我是不是在这条界线上行动，或者我永远不会知道。早唞啦。
I'm feeling mighty lonesome, haven't slept a wink. I walk the floor and watch the door, and in between I drink.Black coffee, love's a hand-me-down brew. I'll never know a Sunday in this weekday room. I'm talking to the shadows from 1 o'clock to 4. And Lord, how slow the moments go when all I do is pour black coffee.